Hello folks, my name is Dan. I'm here with Great Adventure Guide, and we have some major news to talk about today in terms of what is happening this fall at Six Flags Great Adventure. Will Fright Fest happen? How often will the park be open? What are the hours? Will there be scare actors and scare zones? Will there be haunted houses, trails? Will there be entertainment? All of these things we know are in jeopardy because of COVID, but I have some answers from you, a few guesses, but some major answers for you. So stick around to find out everything you need to know about Six Flags Great Adventure this fall. No lie, yesterday I was going to be creating a predictions video as to what I thought was going to happen with Fright Fest at Six Flags Great Adventure in 2020 amidst all the COVID craziness. And so I thought, you know what, before I make the video, let me actually go to Six Flags and ask around to different staff members as to the inside scoop with what's happening with Fright Fest. So I head over to Six Flags, and mind you, there hasn't been like any information on the website, on the app. I was trying to find little clues here and there as to whether or not Fright Fest would happen, but I couldn't find much of anything. So I go to Six Flags, I go over to Season Pass headquarters, there's a guy there, he's really nice, and he starts to dish out all this information as to what is happening in the fall at Six Flags. And I'm super excited because now I know I'm going to be able to bring this information to you guys. All to find out that here that day they had just released the information as to what they were doing with Fright Fest and are not having, but yeah, so the good news for you is that you're gonna get the facts and not just my predictions. Well, I do have some guesses because they haven't spelled out every detail as to what's happening, but for the most part, this is all the information that they've released, so this is, you know, good quality stuff. All right, so Fright Fest at Six Flags Great Adventure in Jackson, New Jersey is not happening this year. There will not be Fright Fest. But the good news is that they are doing something. They've changed the name so that there's no confusion as to, like, you know, you're expecting Fright Fest mazes and scaring and different entertainment, all that kind of stuff, because that's all has to look different this year for the most part. So they've changed the name, and the new name is Hallowfest. So Hallowfest will be different, but have a lot of similarities at the same time to what Fright Fest was. Now, the main difference, other than, you know, the fact that you have to wear a mask when you're in the park and you have to be social distancing and you need to make a reservation. I have some important information about reservations. Stick around at the end of the video if you want to know how you can make sure that you get to go to Hallowfest this year. But aside from all those things, the big change is their entertainment in form of their haunted mazes, their haunted houses, their haunted trails, whatever they're calling them. And that is that the indoor ones will not be open. So, you know, Big Top Terror, I think that's what it was called, and the Manor, Fears, the Mirror Maze, those haunted houses that were occurring inside will not be open. And that's the same with all of their other indoor things at Six Flags. I mean, even their indoor dining, you can get food from those places, but you can't sit and eat inside of the indoor dining locations. Justice League Battle for Metropolis is closed, Houdini's Great Escape, and that is a really popular one in the fall, I know, during Fright Fest. That's not open as well. So all of those indoor mazes, haunted houses will not be open for you. But we should expect to see all of their outdoor haunted trails open. Well, they didn't actually specify which haunted houses that are outside will be open and will be closed, but I'd assume that they'll all be open because they're pretty limited in which ones they can offer anyways. So if you are looking to go to Wicked Woods or Aftermath, the zombie haunted house, Cell Block 6, which I think is probably gonna be the best one considering a lot of those actors can be inside of the actual jail cells and know that, you know, people aren't gonna get too close to them, so they can really live it up and not have to worry about making sure that they're not too close to the people walking through. And Bloodshed, I think is what it was called last year, and it was Hellfest the year before. I have a really sad, pathetic story about Hellfest. All right, so true confessions, I'm not really too into Halloween, at least like I really don't like scary movies and that kind of stuff. And so I never went into haunted houses because I was like, I know that, you know, they can wreck my day. But if you want to hear a ridiculous story about a couple years ago, the first time I finally went to Fright Fest and my experience there, stick around for the end of the video. It's really pathetic. I was 25. I shouldn't, whatever. But Bloodshed should be open. I think those are all the outdoor haunted trails. And I would also expect some outdoor entertainment, but any of the indoor shows that they had before, those will not be happening. It will all be outdoor entertainment, and they need to guarantee that everybody is 6 feet apart in there, so there will be some limited seating and limited capacity just in general around the park. So that's great. Now, another major change is how many scare actors will actually be in the park. They said that there will be a limited number of scare actors, so expect to see less of them, and know that they're always gonna stay 6 feet away from you, which if you're scared to death at these events and you always avoid them because you don't want somebody to be like up in your face in a like creepy clown mask or something like that, that's great for you. This might be your year. Hallowfest might be the thing to go to. But I know that personally, I love those moments where your friends or family members or random strangers have like a clown up over their shoulder and they have no idea that they're there, and then they turn and see them and they pee their pants or fall over. It's just, it's a wonderful time. So we won't be seeing as much of that, but there still will be scare actors throughout the park, and there will be scare zones throughout the park. They have not released which ones will be open, and it is safe to say that there's a good chance that one or two of those scare zones might not be happening. Maybe the scare zone that goes towards Bizarro. I know that usually they have some actors that walk down and around there, which it's pretty dead over there anyways. I could see them not having anyone over there, not setting stuff up over there. So it will be limited in what things actually are open, but there should be some scare actors and some scare zones, and this could be a really good time even with the 6 feet of distance. Don't worry, if scary stuff is not your thing, you can still come be a part of Hallowfest, because these scare actors and the haunted trails, they typically are not going to be opening until 6 o'clock at night. That's when all the scary stuff happens. So you can still get to the park earlier, especially on a Saturday or a Sunday, spend the afternoon there, look at the different decorations, go through one of the trick-or-treating trails, assuming one of those are open, and have a good time on the rides, and then scoot on out of the park as you gets closer to 6 o'clock before things turn around for you. So that will still be an option. But either way, if you want to be a part of Hallowfest, not Fright Fest, Hallowfest, all right, got it right. If you want to be a part of Hallowfest, you need to make a reservation. And these reservations are going to go live at the beginning of September. So if you're a season pass holder, or if you have a membership with Six Flags, then you can make your reservations as early as Thursday, September 3rd. And then everybody else will be able to make a reservation as early as Friday, September 4th. And you're gonna wanna make a reservation as soon as you know that you're planning on going, especially if you wanna go in October, because I know that as you get closer and closer to Halloween, this gets more and more popular. So make sure that you go and make a reservation for Hallowfest as soon as you know that you are planning to go and you know what time you're gonna go and all that good stuff, because that's the only way you're gonna be able to get through the park. You don't need just a ticket, you don't just need a season pass or a membership, you need to make a reservation. And while this summer reservations have been no problem to get, I would imagine that those days in October, those Saturdays closer to Halloween, they're going to sell out, because Fright Fest was hugely popular, and I'm sure that Hallowfest will be very popular as well. So the good news is that there will be some spooktacular things happening at Six Flags Great Adventure this year. Feel free to give my video a dislike just because I use the word spooktacular, which is really pathetic. No, actually, you should give my video a like and subscribe to my channel if you found this information helpful. And check out my other videos. I have some great footage on those videos of different roller coasters and rides, that kind of stuff, as to what's happening at Six Flags Great Adventure. And you best believe that I will be there when when Hallowfest actually begins, and I'll get some footage for you guys and give you tips and tricks on how to have the most successful time at Hallowfest. So be looking forward to that. But if you stuck around this video this long, I'm guessing that you're interested in my pathetic story, so I'm gonna share that right now. The truth is that I hate scary movies and stuff that has to do with horror and that kind of thing. I mean, it's just like, if I watch a scary movie, it will ruin my night. It'll ruin my weekend, probably ruin my week, maybe my month, could ruin my year. It's just, it's bad for my mental, emotional, spiritual health, all of the health things. It's a negative for me. So I've always stayed away from scary movies, and I've also stayed away from haunted houses, because I figured if a movie can destroy me, I can only imagine how much damage a haunted house would do to my everything. And so I've always stayed away from it, but then a friend of mine wanted to go and I was like, fine, I'll go in a haunted house, but like I might go in one haunted house and call it a day because I can't handle these things. So I went, we actually went on the Mirror Maze first, which was like a joke, but then we went into Big Top Terror. We were the only two people in that entire haunted house. So you best believe we were attacked by every single clown. But I quickly realized that this is just a blast. It's fun to be, you know, scared. It's all like jump scare stuff. You can tell, like, I know that those are real people behind the makeup or behind the mask. Like, it's not that big of a deal. And I just had a blast, so much laughter. I highly recommend it if you're into that kind of stuff. It's just, it's really fun. Or especially if someone in your group's not into that stuff and they're terrified, it's all that much funnier. But that night, they were doing Hellfest that year. And if you don't know, Hellfest is a movie that came out a couple years ago, and it's about teenagers that go to like an event like Fright Fest, but there is somebody who's dressed up in a mask that's actually like taking kids and killing them. And it's like super scary, and the teens are trying to tell these other people, that like the security at the park, that there's a killer that's loose, and he's like, you just have a big imagination, you're like, nobody's trying to actually kill you here. And so that already made the entire event, like all of Fright Fest, scarier, because I'm like, could that ever happen? Like, what if like some rogue worker like snuck in some weapon, or, you know? So other than that, like this haunted house was by far the scariest in my opinion. So we're going through it and I'm like on edge the entire time. And then we got to the corn maze section and I lost my mind. It was pathetic. Like, there wasn't even anybody in there. I was shoving the person in front of me, my friend, and anybody else that was like in there. I was like, we need to get through this quicker. I don't want to be in here anymore. I lost my I was 25 years old, people. Like, it should not have been a big deal. I was losing my mind. Needless to say, of course, that was their favorite maze. So we went back in it a second time at the end of the night. But Fright Fest was so much fun in the past. It is so much fun to be around there with friends and family, or just to people watch other people that get scared, especially if you don't get scared and other people's do. Oh, it's great. So I highly recommend it. And I'm sure that Hallowfest is going to be a great time for everybody as well, even though it's going to look differently. So I'm looking forward to that. Thanks for watching this video, and I will catch you guys later.